Dance Today followers. I'm Neil Jones and welcome to my interview. My feelings on American styles expanding into black, I think, is perfect. It's great. It should have happened a long, long time ago. Jokes aside, I would always say it's now making ballroom more interesting. Okay, that moment Richard Porter put me in front of a live ball. We were actually going there to improve my posture for Paso Doble. I'm not sure if it actually improved my Paso Doble or if it just made me faster. It was an experience. I definitely did improve in my Paso over the time. I just wish I actually had a few more lessons with the Matador before they stuffed me in the ring. But I guess it's like, if you want to learn to swim, chuck you in the deep end, it's going to be a lot quicker. If I'm in a competition and the music isn't that great, you know, it's not really inspiring me, I've always worked, again, with Richard Porter in a certain way, that we create our own inner rhythm. So we have a performance and an inner rhythm that before we even enter the competition. And that way, even if the music is really, really bad, I can still connect to that musicality. If the music is great, it's a plus. Then I just have an extra level I can put on top of my normal performance. So I don't really allow the music to bother me so much when I'm competing. I just take that inner rhythm and I make sure that that's already interesting before I enter the floor. I have the biggest passion for creating shows. I love doing it for myself, I like doing it for other people as well. Throughout my life, I've always been asked what inspires me, what helps me create a great show. And actually, it's everyday life situations. I might even just be watching the news and some issue comes up. Like the other day, something was about mental health and how it's a big problem at the moment. So directly, it starts making me think, oh, how could I turn, for instance, a rumble or a Paso Doble into a situation with mental health? And connect that and create a story from beginning to the end. Also on the other side, sometimes simply just props. I might look at a ladder and think, oh, how can I dance with a jive with a ladder? You know, what can I use? And I would just take that ladder and literally keep dancing different movements to see what's possible to use that ladder. So basically, everyday life situations help and inspire me all the time. So next time you're walking down the street, think about that. When you see an object, what could you do with that object? Normally when I go to a competition and I'm looking around, I don't go there to search for a couple. I want that couple to find me. So when I'm looking, what really is important to me is uniqueness in a couple. I'm always searching for the fact that someone grabs my attention. If you're out there and you're thinking, how can I actually make my way through? How can I get a better result? How can I be noticed? To be noticed is to be unique. I've been competing for, I would say, over 25 years. It wasn't until later in my life that I actually realized I actually preferred performing rather than competing. I enjoy the fact of taking control of an audience, lighting, mood, and actually taking them on a journey. And that's why in the past year that I decided not to compete anymore and actually just focus completely on performing, whether it's at a competition, whether just for a show, or whether it's on a stage, on film. For me, it's so much more interesting to perform a show than it is actually. He's a rebel and you'll never be any good.